Atlazzo started in 2011, and before that I have been a journalist for 15 years, and I worked in different online outlets. I worked 10 years at the largest Hungarian news site, and I was the investigative guy in the last 5 years there. And I felt being more and more controlled, and I felt I can't publish any story I wish. And it got worse even before the 2010 changes. I felt that political and economic interests have a say on what to publish or what not to publish, especially in investigative journalism. And it was not only at my former employer, but in other outlets as well. So the journalist had a general feeling that that you need to have some level of self censorship to keep your job. We didn't have a non-profit for investigative journalism that time in Hungary. Now we have more than one, because we have been successful and others started similar projects. But that time it was completely unknown in Hungary, and we started it very small. We started it with zero funding. I have a friend who is an IT expert, and I have a lawyer who was helping me pro bono, and I started it on a blog. And it turned out that there is a huge demand for this type of work in Hungary. So we started the crowdfunding campaign, and people started to donate. And then the Open Society Foundation stepped in, and we received our first grant, so I could have more journalists on board. And that's how it started. And then we decided to go for freedom of information activism, because we think that the basis of the informed citizen is that the public data must be published and must be available. So we localized the freedom of information request generator service, which is an online service where citizens can ask any state institution about public spending, and we started to campaign people, especially on social networks like Facebook, that you know your rights and ask the state about your tax money, and the service became very popular, and a lot of people started to ask questions and file requests through this website. And at the end, the Hungarian government decided to change the law on freedom of information to restrict it, because they felt that they are getting too many requests for public data. We are very proud of this nomination. It is our second international acknowledgement, because in 2012 we got a prize from Global Voices, Breaking Borders Award, and we were very proud of it, because it means international recognition of our work, and we are very proud of this nomination, and we think that it is not only me or not only the Atlazzo people, but everyone who didn't fail to the government and didn't shut up with criticism in Hungary. And I think it's very important to encourage critical media in general in Hungary, because the government is really nasty on independent press nowadays. started